This is a 2012 Equinox. Got a 2.4 liter Ecotec LEA engine. Timing chain's bad, stretched. Also the guide's sawed off. I found some pieces of it in the engine.
One of the ways to know that the timing chain is cutting the upper guide in two without taking the valve cover off is to take the filter out. You'll have metal all in the filter, like this one here. You can actually cut the end of the filter off and then pull the element out. And that's where all your metal end up going. So everything laying here will be replaced. Two new phasers, two new bolts, all the guides, chains, tensioner, upper guide, the sprockets. The only thing I'm not going to replace would be the intake and exhaust counterbalance sprockets. Anything to do with the water pump. I didn't see any wear on any of that, so I'm not going to mess with it. So this is the timing chain setup on the Ecotec engines. Before you take any of the guides, chain, or sprockets off, you need to get this crankshaft key at 12 o'clock. With the crank key at 12, it should be around 2 o'clock on the intake. At 10 o'clock on the exhaust. If your marks up top don't line up at 2 and 10, you need to make one full revolution of this crankshaft back to 12 o'clock. It should show up. So this is the balance shaft kit. It goes in the lower part of the motor, chain, sprocket, guides, and a tensioner. Gonna put that in. So this chain has three links. Two of them are going to be the same. They go here and here. The unique one goes on the intake up here. It's too hard to see up there. But it's on the top up here. This one here is the same color as this one down here. It goes on the exhaust and the air is here. There's a dot on this one down here that lines up with that link. Now that we have these hand tight, we can go around and torque them. This is 89 inch pounds, 106, 106, 106, and 106 inch pounds. Take and lower your upper guide and the motor. So these camshaft sprockets or phasers have a peg in them. They're only going the camshaft one way and in one spot. To make them easier to put on, you can mark the camshaft like this here. I always take and put a mark here and here. Here and here. These are just reference marks. That's not a timing mark. These help when you put the cam phasers on, because sometimes you have to rock these cams back and forth. This just gives you a point where you know where the cams were at when you started. Take your phaser and intake.
So right here on the front is the access plug. There's a bolt behind it for the stationary guide. Take this out, you can get to that bolt. Sometimes this bolt will break off behind it. They make a access plug with the guide bolt built onto it. When you screw this in, it holds the guide and seals the hole.
So on this phaser here, it's 22 foot-pounds, plus 100 degrees. You can take one of these 363 gauges and cut it out. It's 100 degrees here. Take you some paint. Mark it there. Mark it there. That's 100 degrees. Next thing you want to do is put a dot on the socket. Then bring that socket around. It matches up with the other paint mark. You have 100 degrees.
So we have our phasers on, 22 foot-pounds plus 100 degrees on these bolts here. They're supposed to be new because they're torqued to yield. This is what the timing mark should look like. So this is what it looks like when you get all your guides on. This is the timing chain guide. This is the stationary guide here. It goes up the top. This is your balance chain guides. This is your oiler. This is what the crank should look like here on the dot, down here on the dot. Make sure you pull this pin here. I've already pulled it. That pin there, that'll engage this tensioner. I already put tension on this, the balance chain. This is the mark up here on the arrow. There's a unique one up top up there. You can see it now. Yeah, you can, it's right in there. Timing chain tensioner is located on the back of the motor down in this area. It's 55 foot-pounds, has a torque on it. To engage the tensioner, take a wood dowel, go right down the top here, on top of the timing chain.
Just take the rubber mallet and tap the hammer, and that'll unlock the tensioner. You can also use an extension. You just need to put some on the end of it so it doesn't damage the top of the chain, because you will be hitting on top of the chain.
Before you put the timing cover on, or the valve cover, you take a ratchet, turn this motor over 720 degrees slowly, make sure there's no interference with the valves. If you make contact with one of them, stop. You probably hit it when the timing's off. You want to retime the motor.
So the next thing you want to check are the solenoid controlled actuators. They control the phasers on the end of the cam. They've got an O-ring here. And they have a bolt in. You take this one bolt out, you can pull this out of the head. They're located right on top of the head, close to the timing chain. So the problem you have with these solenoids is this middle port here will build up metal on it, or just the screen that gets stopped up. And this is the outlet. And the outlet, this in here turns the cam one way. This one here turns the cam the other way. It controls this phaser. If this gets stopped up, no oil can get in through the screen, so no oil will come out here. So this phaser can't be controlled by the ECU. So it throws some codes. You'll have an over-advance code, over-retarded code. Also, you can have an open circuit code, which means the solenoid is probably bad. It's not plugged in, or the wire coming into the plug is bad.